making music together is nothing. Nothing is better than that. You know, you work off each other. You listen to each other. Most important thing is to listen, because a lot of people just play their part and they don't care what's going on over there. You really have to listen to what he's doing, and he's listening to what I'm doing. There's and not a lot of people can do that. I was really, probably 3 or maybe 4 years ago, it was at Wilson, Sherrilyn Wilson Center, right over here. Are you familiar with that Sherrilyn Wilson Center? It's a concert hall right over here, and it's also a school. They had a competition, I think chamber ensemble and piano competition. And I just listened to a concert of members of a jury. So they played, you know, whatever, 1-2 pieces each. And there was one woman, she's originally from Korea, Joyce Yang, I think her name is. She's just, she's very young. She was in Juilliard, a friend of mine who teaches in Juilliard, he knows her, she knows her. And that was the best ever I saw anyone accompanying or playing with someone. It was like breathing together. That's like a God-given gift, you know, not a lot of people. I don't know anyone who can do it like that, to be honest with you. That's the best I've ever, ever heard. Joyce, if you would just go on YouTube, Joyce Yang, I think her last name is, if I'm not mistaken. I'm so bad with names. But yeah, she graduated from Juilliard, and then she went somewhere else, and now she's traveling the world. I just saw her with Milwaukee Symphony last year playing first concerto of Tchaikovsky, which was fabulous, by the way. Fantastic. It's like a, we just talk. Okay, what are we going, how are we going to start?
Well, I don't know, what do you want to do?
We'll start on C or F. We'll figure it out eventually. Okay, let's vamp on F. Okay. You start. It's F minor, so I have to kind of figure it out. Thank you. lot of fun. Solid rock. I actually started playing different tune, actually.
I noticed that.
Okay, well, as I said, it's very important to listen to what your partner is doing. Do you, let's do old blues.
Old blues, absolutely.
Classic tune.
Miles Davis.
Yeah, Miles Davis, exactly. And there's nothing happening. It's just a major, you know, a couple other chords, but that's it. Mm-hmm. But so much music. In between the notes. Yeah, do you play guitar?
No.
Okay. You start.
Okay.
See, that's how I avoid responsibility. I'm just saying. Let's start.
Here we go.
I'll play one note. Second note. Notes. That's the case. Thank you. I love Tom. I know Tom forever. And he's awesome.
Thank you.
Can we do a little dedication to Miss Anita before we wrap it up? Is that okay?
Oh, sure.
Just a little quick one.
That would be great, but explain what you were doing with that vamping, that you just made that up.
Of course, I made it up. Yeah.
Well, that means they don't know. It's not a spot.
Well, yeah, I said, but we have no idea what we're doing. But
yeah. That was on
we're
the
playing.
Spot. That was on the spot. Just
yeah.
In a C minor.
C minor, major. I actually, do you know what I was going to do? I was going to do that.
Learn that. That's great.
Oh, really?
Perfect.
Oh, I could do that.
Yeah, you know, Star Wars.
That's a good thing about like drawn. You just play one note at the bottom, and whatever you play on top, you know.
It's
you can
good.
Do whatever.
It's okay.
Okay. Let's
earlier, he's one of my favorite composers and
mine as well.
I think you feel the same.
Yeah.
Here's one for Anita because tomorrow's her anniversary.
Oh. Yay. Okay.
Just once through.
I love Tom, I already told you. Find someone you want to play with, somebody who plays different instrument. You will discover a totally different world, and you will love it. I absolutely guarantee you. If person is good, who you are playing with, that is just phenomenal. Just like playing with Tom. Nothing can be better than that. Okay, well, thank you again. Thank you for coming. Thank you for listening to my ramblings about life and music. And now,
any questions, anyone? Briefly?
Do you have a favorite composer?
Oh, that's a trick question. No, well, I do, but I have many of them.
Okay.
I can go down the list, and it's going to be a very eclectic list. Classical, obviously, my background, I have PhD in piano music, so it's classical is obviously probably on top, but there are a lot of jazz musicians, but also a lot of country musicians, believe it or not, and fusion, jazz fusion artists as well. Yeah.
Okay.
I can tell you that my favorite composer ever is Bach, Johann Sebastian Bach. But he's not the only one. There are a bunch of musicians. Rachmaninoff, for example, is another incredible composer, which I love his work. French composers, Debussy, Ravel, Beethoven, there is no question about Beethoven, obviously. Mozart is, I always felt like music is, classical music, Western music, is based on three main, I don't know even how to say it, you know, stones, rocks, you know, it rests on these three rocks. It's Bach, Beethoven, and Mozart. That's how I look at it. Bach is all about polyphonics. Mozart is all about melody, and Beethoven is all about the form construction. And that's the basis. But it doesn't, it's not just that. You know, obviously, Stevie Wonder, for example, you know, a lot of people will say, well, he's a pop musician. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but he's a pop musician which changed the face of music forever. And that's, it takes a lot. Like, for example, I don't know if you know Bruce Hornsby, for example. Musician, keyboard player, and a singer. He developed something which most people never develop, his own style. He's extremely recognizable. You hear a few notes, you know that it's Bruce Hornsby. George Duke, late George Duke, he was with Zappa for a very, very long time, influenced in a big way. Oscar Peterson, obviously. I mean, Keith Jarrett, if you just go down the list, Chick Corea, which I mentioned before, Miles Davis. I love guitarists, you know, some guitarists, Larry Carlton, you know, and people like that. But Segovia, classical guitarist. So there are a lot of composers. Music is, world of music is so vast at this particular point. And you can find anything on YouTube. Like, for example, I'm listening lately to a composer, his name is Cristobal de Morales. And he is a Spanish composer. He of 15th century. He composed a bunch of choral music, church music, you know, like requiems and messes and stuff like that. I listen to him all the time because I find him just so fresh and so incredibly powerful. But most people don't know and probably never will know who this guy is. But since I discovered him, and it takes time to discover, you know, things. I stumbled upon him because I really like medieval music, and when I was working on my Christmas album, which has a lot of medieval kind of influence and music kind of associated with it, that's kind of my universe. I tried to keep it kind of in a medieval vein. That's how I discovered Cristobal de Morales, which was only 4 years ago. And since then, he became one of my favorite composers. There's Gesualdo, there's Orlando Di Lassi, you know, you just go down the list, you know, obviously. And I don't know, well, now I'm blanking, senior moment.
My favorites, who wrote, Jobim and Gershwin. And
Gershwin, oh, yeah, Jobim, yeah. I love Jobim. Obviously. I love ethnic music, I listen to a lot of African music. Folk music, African folk music, or African even pop music. That's very unique and totally different from what our experiences are, especially mine. Betsy Cline, a good example, you know. I think she's just an incredible singer, and her songs are incredible, and Crazy, which wasn't written by her, you know, was written by...
Willie Nelson.
Willie Nelson, yeah. Exactly. You know, as I said, music is just a... I would say there are two things in the world which for me are proof of existence of God. It's art and music and love. All of it is unexplainable. You can't explain it. There's no way to logically kind of put things together and explain how it all works, because nobody knows. Where does it come from? I mean, I have no idea where it comes from, but it does something, that I know for sure. I listened to a piece of music which was composed in 1422, and it makes me cry. Why? I don't know why, but it does. It has an effect on me. I listen to Crazy. Yeah, that makes me cry. Yeah. Or Jolene by, what's her name?
Dolly Parton.
Yeah. What a wonderful song. I don't know if she ever composed it, but.
She wrote most of her music. Anyway, my battery is just dying. I think we're at the
wonderful. I also want to say something. Most musicians never become musicians because they think they're not good enough. Because they feel like, oh, well, world already has a Beethoven and Bach and Mozart, you know, or Dolly Parton, or you know, Patsy Cline, or Oscar Peterson. I will never be as good as them. That this single attitude, that's what killed most artists in the world. But they just gave up and decided that they will never do anything. Well, granted, you know, some of them gave up and became something else. Like, you know, I love photography. Ansel Adams, you know Ansel Adams? Mm-hmm. Ansel Adams is one of, arguably, probably the most celebrated American photographer of wildlife, you know, and landscapes and stuff like that. He wanted to be a piano player. But his fingers were too short, and he decided that he never will amount to anything. He gave up and started doing photography. And today, you know, he's one of the most celebrated photographers in the world. Boris Pasternak, who wrote Dr. Zhivago, wanted to be a classical piano player. But after he heard Scriabin playing in concert his music, he said, that's it, I give up. He gave up and became a writer, incredible writer. Nobel Prize winner. So, but most people just give up and they're never happy. And that's horrible. Just because they're fear of being judged. Can you imagine somebody would tell Van Gogh, listen, don't even try. You're not good, you know. And what would happen with the world of art? It would be totally different today without him, but he single-handedly. And you know how long he was painting actually? For how long? From beginning to the end.
His whole life. Well, oh, how many years?
You know how long? 8 years. That's it. From beginning to the end. He never painted before. And then he killed himself. You know, 8 years, that's it.
But look at the gift he gave to the world.
Yes. Yeah. And the world never would be the way it is today without him. Yeah. Just like music, which we play today, never would be like that, without Mozart and Cristobal de Morales and Jobim, and you know, because everyone brings something beautiful to the world, reminds us that the world is actually beautiful, and that's what, and we are beautiful, and that's, I think that's what music does. It reminds us that we're actually beautiful, instead of
a perfect note to this.
Oh, thank you.
We like that.
It's
great. Yes. Yeah, so
who wants to play this piano?